Hello everyone, hi, make sure she's 87, and this is Let's Play Tales of Asiria Part 68. In the previous video, we wandered around for a while, eventually made it to Capital Nor, where Patty was revealed to be Ifrid, and then nobody questioned it at all. They said, we'll explain it in due time, and it's like, we could explain it now, but also Duke's got a big flying castle now, and I complained about the story taking a bit of a nosedive. And since I did that, I should, because I don't really like just saying something's bad without saying what I think would make it better, we'll briefly talk about my main things I would change for the story that I think would make it maybe not good. I mean, I don't know. I mean, I'm not trying to say, oh, I can make the story so much better. That's not the intent here. It's just things that I think would make me enjoy it more. First things first, you just delete Alexei from the game. Like, just straight up delete any and all, just his entire thing. He's gone. Instead, you replace him with Duke, because Duke is just a better version of Alexei. And if you're going to have Duke as an antagonist anyway, you may as well just cut to the point. And instead, have the main conflict. I mean, you can basically keep almost everything intact, right? The Autophagos can still be, like, the major big bad. But the thing is that the Autophagos is not a character, it's a plot device. So you still have to have somebody stand in to be like the real antagonist in the story, which they've done with Duke now, but they took too long and his reasoning doesn't really make much sense. So instead, the way I think you do it is you set up Duke as the antagonist by... There's two ways. You can either keep him as a genocidal monster who wants to kill all humans, or you could have it be that he's the one that wants to destroy all the Blastia. So basically, since Alexei's not here, you don't do the thing with Zalde. Because really, the only purpose of the thing in Zalde was to set up the Autophagos as like an immediate threat. But then the story just went back and is chilling. So we can just keep the Autophagos there as it's being held back by a barrier. But overuse of Blastia over the... you know, following centuries since they were supposed to be done away with has made the air really thick in the planet, and the Autophagos is getting stronger and stronger off of it because it's seeping through. Eventually, in the near future, the Autophagos will break through the barrier and kill everyone. The Duke doesn't think that there's any way for humanity to beat Autophagos, because even when the Entelechia and humans were at their peak, all they could do was seal it away, and now that so many of the Entelechia have been killed, there's no shot that it can be defeated. So he sees the only way of being able to stop the Autophagos is to completely cut off the creation of any new heir, which would mean either A, destroying all humans, or probably better, is it just he wants to destroy all the Blastia, which is still a bad thing, right? Because the problem with destroying all the Blastia is that human survival kind of depends on it because of the wolves, as I keep mentioning. I mean, you just like can't leave cities and like in universe because it's so dangerous. And the only reason cities are allowed to exist is because of the Blastia, because it's, you know, such a dangerous planet they live on. So it's still something to oppose, and you can still have Yuri and everyone else looking for a third way via the spirits. And you can still set up Duke as the main antagonist, who's much more interesting than Alexei's I want to conquer the world or something. Still really don't fully understand what he thought Zod did. I guess he thought it was like a laser beam and he could use it to make himself emperor. I don't know. Which does beg the question of, like, if he's had a fundamental misunderstanding of what Zod does, why didn't we ever tell him what it did or what it was going to do? Because I feel like we knew. But yeah, that would be the main thing. Just completely delete Alexei. Plus, that would have the side effect of making the game a bit shorter, because I do think it's too long for what story is here. I'm trying to think. Because that solves the objective of it gets rid of all the Alexei shit, which is like just not good at all. It elevates Duke as a character, right? He's not just like, I'm going to murder all people. Or even if he is going to murder all people, have it be that the Autophagos is not here yet. It's that the Autophagos will come and kill everyone unless all people are dead, and he just values the Entelechia more because they can live in harmony with nature, whereas humans cannot live without Blastia, basically. So that would be my corrections that wouldn't change too much. It still keeps the core plot and everything intact, but I think it flows a lot better and makes Duke...
We finally got you! Where have you been wandering around?
...a better character, and having it not be that the Autophagos has already broken through gets rid of this weird dissonance where you have the big cutscene where the Autophagos comes down and then it just immediately fucks off for some reason and has just been chilling up in the sky for who knows how long, not doing anything.
Yuri... Lowell.
Oh, shut up. God. Was there like a... Like, do you not... She doesn't say anything. Why are you in the game?
Sodia?
So what's up with Flynn?
Oh, right.
Why aren't
Many
you in
people
prison?
Have fled this continent since that monster covered the sky. But some opposed using a guild fleet to protect the Empire. Flynn could not abide that. A fleet attacked by monsters landed on Hypionia. We fought, but they kept gaining.
We alone were sent for aid, but all the knights are spread all over the world.
We have no other choice but to ask for your help.
No?
But we're too late. Commander Flynn must be...
We got bigger fish to fry. Did you not see the Doom Fortress? Like, especially since we've established Duke has access to a Doom Fortress, it could just be, oh, he's going to use the Doom Fortress to destroy all the Blastia at once. Right? Like, we have like a... something that can function as the plot device to explain that. And so it's like you have to go stop Duke to prevent him from doing that, but then also at the same time you're cooking on the spirits idea. You know, instead of spending all the time at Alexei, we would just replace that with looking for a way to potentially defeat the Autophagos if it does break through.
Wow, could you be any more worthless?
What did you say?
You give up already? Everything you've done, what was it all for?
I did it all for Commander Flynn.
No you didn't. You stabbed him because you're jealous.
Even that one time.
Huh. You talk about doing it all for Flynn, but you're just whining. You gave up. You forgot your resolve.
Resolve?
I mean, if she had any, like, if she was, like, even a slightly decent character, she would put herself in prison. Because it's like, oh, because the reason she's supposed to hate Yuri is because he, you know, operates outside of the law. So once she, you know, becomes overcome with emotion and stabs Yuri and, you know, for all intents and purposes, killed him, he only survived because Yuri's the main character. Like, she should, if she had any integrity whatsoever, she would be like, put me under the prison.
Yo, Applehead. You said Hypionia, right?
Yeah.
Bro, what about the Doom Fortress?
All right, I'll be back soon.
Can't we just go there?
All of you get ready to go to Tarkaron.
I'm going too.
Yeah, me too! You keep forgetting us!
It's like the 27th time.
I'm glad you want to come, but this seems pretty bad.
You do know we're fighting the ultimate evil at the end, Yuri. That's like our stated plan.
That's even more reason not to let you go alone.
Like the existential threat that can destroy the world. But you're like, oh no, you guys can't handle some wolves.
I don't think Baul will listen to you either.
All for the guild and the guild for all, right?
Well, if we're out of time, let's go and get it over.
I will follow you to the day I die, and with more moxie than a snapping moray eel.
Okay, okay, so let's get going.
Yeah! Brave Vesperia, char!
Yeah, definitely
go
the game is too long. I mean, honestly, you could cut like 3 hours out just getting rid of the, I'm gonna go off alone. No, I'll come too. No, don't forget about me. No, not me too. Hey, you weren't thinking about leaving me, were you?
All right, Sodia. Let's reform the support units.
Oh, okay. Yuri Lowell. Yuri Lowell! Why? Why didn't you call me out for my actions that time? I tried to kill you!
I mean, essentially you did.
Oh, I'm not letting it go.
You're on the fucking top of the list. We just got bigger fish to fry.
But I don't have time to deal with someone who gave up on everything.
I haven't given up.
No? So why haven't you gone to help Flynn, even alone? You wanted to protect him so badly you'd kill me! Why won't you protect him now?
I can't protect him by myself. Please... save him, please.
You don't have to tell me to do that.
Please.
You know, there's one thing I agree with you on. I'm a criminal. I could be killed anytime. Flynn is the perfect knight. A perfect leader. He doesn't need a criminal by his side.
He's so perfect, why does he always need Yuri to help him out?
I'm just standing in until the right person comes along.
Yuri.
Hey, friends, where the fuck is Aponia?
Flynn always seems to put himself in danger.
He's always that way. He doesn't mind getting hurt if it means protecting others.
Yeah, he gets a little crazy sometimes.
Like you're any different. Birds of a feather, right?
I'd say we're all like that.
Like what?
We all stuck with brave Vesperia, even when the going got rough.
I guess none of us can just let things go.
Right, so we can't just let Flynn go either.
Yeah, exactly.
Well, since we can't let it go, I think it's time we get a little crazy.
All right. Whatever you say, Red Man. Is Aponia the main continent? This is Maya Sia, what the hell is that? Okay. Tolbikia is to the north. So maybe here. Yeah. Yeah.
Is that it down there?
That's some cloud of dust! Are those all monsters?
This seems to be a counter-effect of Astal's losing control.
Who the hell is Astal? Oh, is that the person, the one that was flying around and then got killed?
It's as if the monsters of the world all came and gathered here.
Is Flynn really down there somewhere?
Probably.
What next? Are we gonna fight every single one of them?
Yeah, sure, why not?
Fine by me. Just give us 2 days and we'll beat them all. Probably.
Two? You can't be serious!
Rita, can't we use that Dane Nomos you made?
You gonna blow them away like doing it to the Atafagos?
Right. Applying directivity to the power of spirits and forming a barrier-like force field to eliminate the monsters.
Yes, it should be possible.
But this was made to be used against the Atafagos, right?
May as well give it a test run.
But this is our only option now.
I mean, nothing says we can only use it once.
To use it now or wait till later? This is quite the conundrum.
I mean, I don't see any reason why we can't, because we're just using up the materials. We can just buy more of those.
Could you let us use it, please?
I beg you to. The Dane Nomos. I want to believe it can save mankind.
And we really should test it before fighting the existential threat.
Yes, if we can't deal with this easily, there is no way we could stand up against the Atafagos.
All right, let's do it.
It's rare to hear Yuri ask for a favor like that.
It's our chance to do Yuri a favor!
Wolf.
Cut it out, guys.
So, what's our plan?
Activate it in the area where the monsters are all concentrated. That's it. Simple, right?
So do they like, is it gonna vaporize them or are they just gonna get pushed away?
Yeah, it is.
No kidding.
Why don't we give it a name? We can't just call it the Rita Dane Nomos.
The RDN? I mean, that kind of flows off the tongue.
Huh? I'll leave it up to you.
No, you fool. You complete and total idiot. Why would you let Carol name anything? God damn it.
I got it! How about the Vesperia number one?
Carol, why is your ass so bad at naming shit?
I should have known better.
It's got a nice ring to it.
What are
Besides,
you talking about?
It's nice and simple.
Don't enable him! Call it like Shining Force or something at least.
Even Baul will
Mirror Force, that's what you should fucking
I'll
call
land
it.
Further away.
The Vesperia Mirror Force. Activate my trap card.
Okay, let's do it.
Wolf. Are you fucker? I saw you move, repeat.
What a mess.
What if our barrier fucks up and it kills everything? Not just, like, how does that work? How does it differentiate between humans and monsters?
We're going in!
I've never really thought about, because I mean, I guess it's always just been like, I don't know. I don't really know. I don't think they've ever really explained how barriers work. Like, why can people walk through them
over there,
but humans can't?
Flynn!
Or, I mean, why can people walk through them, but monsters can't?
Hey, looks like it could use some help.
I can't see anything.
We should hurry. No need for caution. Just charge right in.
Damn true.
Let's go. Stay close.
Great pirate
symbol. Anyway, what is the Maristella?
Hey, I know we're like in the battle, but
they are the great pirate symbols. When they are united, they'll open the gates to paradise.
Paradise?
That wow, sounds like really?
Rubbish. Have
you
some
really
imagination.
Are an airhead. There are dozens of tales of paradise from all ages and all over the world, and none of them are true.
Well,
but
she's kind of.
People who
she's
turn legends
right.
into reality, right?
So what's this paradise like?
Who knows?
Where
skewers?
Is it located?
Skewers
don't
everywhere.
Know.
Is there anything you do know?
Mystery is part of the romance. It's like your magical research, Rita.
My research gives clear-cut answers. Don't compare it to your fairy tales.
Patty, it's useless trying to explain it to someone like Rita.
Hey. You said use it. So, okay, never mind, you can't use it. you use the item? Maybe we use it in combat? Limit fever. That's pretty cool. Avoid staggering when hit during a base art combo in advance or critical form. I mean, that seems very good. Overlimit will not end while using a burst art. That's kind of like whatever. I presume you learned everything here. Yeah, but like the problem is nobody knows how Patty works.
Mighty large!
One at a time.
You said use it. Okay, I got baited. They got mass. I mean, you guys aren't that strong. So.
What?
Please.
Sorry.
Oh, fuck. I didn't realize that'd make you restart your cast. I didn't know you were already casting. Wait, I told you the angel ring, damn it. Fuckers won't listen to me, man.
Don't overdo it.
They just keep spawning in. Hank Castell has logged on.
Here we are.
The brilliant angels grant us your favor.
All right, who's next?
I guess it couldn't spawn in all the enemies at once, so they had to come in as reinforcements. I mean, they do hate Estelle.
Brilliant.
Which, I mean, I guess you gotta respect that hater energy. Or if you get the hell out of my party. Why are you even in the party? I don't even remember putting you in.
We won! That's the cry of victory!
Guess practice.
I thought I had Judy in. Because, I mean, I guess Patty got kicked out of the party, but then they're like, add Patty back, but like, she was already in the party. I am gonna reply. I don't know. We're fighting a bunch of enemies at once. Rita kind of like sucks because she could never cast. I mean, she's paradoxical. In theory, the magic is good because it's AoE, but they will never cast. I mean, as you saw from Estelle, she spent the entire time running around, but sure. We'll risk it for the biscuit. I mean, I guess we don't want to fight you guys then. We're just running to find like, I don't know what I'm doing.
Stop them! Show them what an Imperial Knight can do!
I do think it was funny. Flynn was like in vision, but then you have to run for like 14 minutes to actually get to him.
I say we are done for!
And by 14 minutes, I mean like 30 seconds, but...
This is the end.
You idiots! Stop your whining! Gah!
Damn!
Oof.
You alive?
Yuri! What are you doing here?
Thank your second in command for thinking of you.
Sodia? Huh.
Oh yeah, we killed her because it was our right.
But our current situation's bad. It's only a matter of time until we fall.
We have a little special something.
It may also not work, so don't get your hopes up.
What?
Rita made it in one night with a box of scraps.
Light this thing up in the middle of the monsters, and then watch it go boom!
Will it hurt us? We don't know.
In the middle of the monsters, there are a lot to get through.
Come on, it's us. This is nothing.
All right, let's go.
Hey, we're gonna go turn this thing on. Keep things going here.
Just you two? Are you stupid?
We cannot let our guard down here.
You expect me to believe Patty's 50 years old? Are you stupid?
If we can't defend this place, we lose the very reason for taking out the monsters.
This isn't to defeat the monsters. This is to protect the people.
That's right.
Understood. Leave it to us.
We'll do everything we can.
Much obliged.
Take care, you two.
Pardon, but everyone, Flynn joined the party? Okay, never mind. Sorry, Rita, but you were gonna get some action.
Right.
I guess we kept Repeat. Apparently Repeat does never count as everyone, now that I think about it. They do that all the time, where they say parted with everyone, but Repeat's still there. God damn it, Repeat. You don't have your accessory! You're useless without your accessory, because you have no mana!
Hey, don't go getting yourself ripped apart!
You'll get yourself killed if you keep watching me fight!
Come on! I'm just in awe of the great Flynn Shifo.
Shut up!
Hey, this isn't the time to get worked up.
I am not worked up!
It's okay, don't hide it.
Would you be serious for once?
I am serious.
I can't concentrate with you talking all the time.
Well, I can't concentrate without talking, so we're kinda stuck.
Quailing havoc!
And the difference between like the actual like story and the character dialogue is so crazy. Because, like, the character dialogue is so good and fun.
Dragon Swarm!
And has, like, so much personality. And then the actual main story is just, what were they thinking?
Dragon Swarm! Dragon!
Sorry.
Tiger!
Hey, does anybody notice Flynn's not fucking doing anything?
Quailing havoc!
Oh, he's like, are you, like, turned to stone or something? I got really mad for a second. It's because he's already on note. What the hell? Don't we have a stone bottle? We've never been stoned in the entire game.
That'll be a pain.
And I guess because he was talking. The thing right in front of you. It's low A. It was weird when we got onto him. My brain went like, that's like a party member. That's a person's name. Little Trails reference, I guess. Now I know it's just like German, but that was in my brain. I was like, do we have a party member named Loe?
Dragon!
You alright?
Dragon! Dragon Sword! Wailing Havoc! Atomic Circle! Gas Swarm! Dragon!
I really wish I'd... I mean, I had two decisions back there. I could have kept Repeat in the party, or... and given him the accessory, or kicks him out. I wish I'd given him the accessory. I don't know why he goes through mana so much faster than everybody else.
I shall use this.
Wailing Havoc! Guardian Field!
World's weakest heal just dropped.
Tiger Blade! Dragon!
Flynn, you're still not doing anything.
Sorry.
Dragon Sword!
That thing spawn in and immediately die. Can I use the... am I supposed to use the thing? No? This is kind of neat. Now repeat eating all my mana. Or like, using so much mana to do not that much. Like, you don't have to use Apple, dude. Like, we have Melanges. Okay, we are getting a little, like, trapped. Okay, you do a beast, man. I don't even remember what it's called. Yeah, beast him. Or don't. Just do whatever you want, Flynn. Don't listen to my orders. Flynn, do you know Dragon Swarm? Is that what you just said? You can't just like steal all our moves, Flynn. Flynn really is like the we have Yuri at home though. You see his Dragon Swarm? He got like two hits in.
Dragon Swarm!
See, a proper Yuri Dragon Swarm doesn't get any hits in, because wouldn't it be funny if after you hit an enemy three times, they always turn invisible? I mean, invincible? Okay, well, we should have over-limited, but... looks like we're kind of done now.
You're done!
Pretty good, Commandant.
You're not too bad either.
Fought a billion enemies, still get one third of a level.
I can do even better than this.
I've unlocked new strength.
Well, that was actually pretty neat.
We're about to the middle.
I'm still up for some more fighting.
You look like you're actually having fun in the middle of all this.
You do too.
Now, Yuri.
Right. Take this!
And then it doesn't work and we die at the end. I think that's gonna produce a lot of air. Or does it not because it's spirit magic, or, but also, which I don't really get.
There. That should be okay for now.
Because isn't Estelle's spirit magic, and it also produces air, like, even more than Blastia's?
Thank you so much.
Your Highness.
Don't push yourself, okay? Vesperia number one broke, huh? I'm sorry.
Yeah, seems like the materials we used to make the body were too brittle.
It was our fault.
No, it wasn't. It was the monster's fault.
Don't worry, the core's fine, and I can repair it. It's just...
what a sad ending.
Patty, that's not the line. My brain broke for a second, because I'm like, there are more words in the text box than what she said, So I was waiting for the extra dialogue, but it kept being silent. And I was like, wait, that's not what she was supposed to say.
Estelle has saved their lives, but they shouldn't move for a while.
I guess we have to stay and defend them for a little more.
Like, it like literally short-circuited my brain. So I was like, what? How did you finish that text so fast? But wait, there's more words there than what she said. And they're the wrong words.
So why not just make this a fort? It's been a while, Yuri. I've heard stories about brave Vesperia.
You got my fucking spear?
I guess the mercenaries I hired weren't sufficient. Sorry for the trouble.
I'm sure the guilds are in chaos right now, too. Thank you for your help.
It won't really make up for things, but I'll help with the defense.
You're going to fight?
Oh no, I'm a merchant. Just watch.
Commander Flynn, you're alive!
Fuck off. I mean, actually, I guess, Witcher, you're okay. Your voice is just annoying.
Witcher! Is something wrong?
I mean, it's not really. I mean, you know. I mean, I recognize the voice actor. She's in a lot of stuff, but...
Yes, that tower near Ospio has created an unusual formula around itself.
It's just something about a little kid sounding like that. I don't know, it just seems uncanny.
Judging by the crests, it's absorbing some kind of power. In addition, all residents throughout Illichia have reported feeling strange.
Absorbing? Feeling strange? Is it absorbing human life?
It also just makes me think of Clover from 999, who I will never forgive.
Duke.
Life is very pure mana. Does he intend to use it to attack?
This is what he meant by exchanging all human life to destroy the Autophagos.
Can't you just, like, slurp up the monsters? There's, like, infinite monsters in this universe. That's, like, another thing that they really should, like, address. Why are there so many monsters? Are they different than Intellikea? Because we do need to come up with a solution for the monsters if we're going to live in a post-Blastia world.
The formula is expanding in stages. At this rate, it could affect the entire world.
Because as it stands, like, humans are just going to be slaughtered en masse as soon as they get rid of Blastias.
No!
We can't just stand around.
But the spirit's power alone won't be enough.
Even if we repair Vesperia number one, that alone won't be enough.
What? But it took out all those monsters!
Judging by the size of the Autophagos, we'd need several hundred times the power.
Several hundred? That's gonna be tough.
Facing this calamity is going to take an insane amount of power.
Hey, let's use your magical doodads.
I guess we have no choice but to change the cores to spirits.
I guess we can't do that because you're like you're not real content, Patty, as we talked about last time.
Wait, could you explain what you're talking about?
Like the story has to be able to resolve itself without Patty because apparently it came out originally without her.
Oh yeah, we meant to talk to you all about it. Hey Flynn, we want to tell Yoder and the guilds too. Can you call them here?
Oh, Yuri. You seriously want him to call the Emperor to a place like this?
Yeah. The world's about to end, dummy.
You never change.
I could say the same for you, Yuri.
What?
Okay, I'll see what I can do.
I mean, he doesn't deserve to be Emperor if he's not gonna be. I mean, granted, nobody deserves to be Emperor, but at the very least, you should be willing to slightly inconvenience yourself for the fate of the entire human race.
In exchange, you all go talk to the people of the Union in Palastrali.
Okay.
So I guess we're off to Dawngrest in Nordopolica?
Or can't we just go to the Doom Castle?
Yeah. Mind giving us a ride?
Man, I really thought this game was going to end at Zod, too. Which, I mean, on one hand, I mean, overall, I do think this third act has been pretty decent to good. Like, a lot better than the Alexei stuff. Well, I don't know. Decent. I don't know if I'd say it's... maybe I'm just riding high. Because this section was really cool. This thing with Flynn and everything, I really enjoyed. Mainly because it's more character focused. And the character writing is still really good. That's the one thing the game's mainly got going for it, to me at least. Which is nice, because characters are the thing I care about the most. But I do think you kind of need to have, like, I wish the other two pillars of of combat and story were better. And the combat's not bad, I just don't like it. I mean, she's my wife, so it's okay. I just, fucking my wife, am I right, boomers? I had no idea I could get this dark at night. This is clearly no time for business. But now the problem is, what happened to get us out of here? I do think it was funny, though, like, how mad I got about Flynn being stoned, even though it was technically my fault. Because, like, I guess I've never seen that icon before, because that's, I'm pretty sure we've never had anybody get stoned before. Because, like, I saw the icon on him, but I thought it was, like, one of these other things that I don't know what the fuck they are. Like, I thought he was weak or something. And I guess since he was talking, because I really did think his ass was just chilling, like he was doing in the, what boss fight was that? The one that I got tilted at him not doing anything? When was that? Because it wasn't... Wasn't we fought Alexei? Because it wasn't Jaeger. Oh, was it the big golem? Was that the one where he wouldn't do anything? I don't remember. I think it was the big golem. Because that was part of the reason why I was so annoying. On top of just the, your attacks bouncing off. It was just that Flynn wouldn't do anything. Now, granted, I guess I could have changed his weapon, but I didn't know you could do that, because... I don't know. And plus, the only reason I even know that the reason he wasn't attacking was because of elemental weaknesses is because I was told that apparently the AI breaks if they have an elemental weapon, and... you're fighting an enemy that's resistant to their elemental weapon, they just won't attack instead, which doesn't make any sense to me. I'm a man, a real man don't whine. Yeah, okay, whatever. Came back from orders to protect Zophius. Me, a whiner, I reject that. Everyone has barely escaped with their lives. We knights must protect those who have escaped with us. I'm not gonna lose those knights. I'll show you what guildsmen can do. I'll cut those monsters up to pieces with this sword. I'll show you how to protect civilians. I think at this job, thinking I can make some quick cash. What have I got myself into? I don't think I'm cut out for this job. It's time for me to show you what I can do. Next time you're back, this town is gonna be... town? It's a... like, open field. No matter what, I'm gonna protect her. That's what this experience has made me decide. It's nice to be thought of as important, but this guy's so serious, it's scary. Where do I go? I don't know what I don't know what you know or what you're thinking about right now. Okay, I'll brain broke for a second there. I'm sure His Highness would agree to that too. That tower built by the mages in Asphio? Rita, don't hide it anymore. Just tell us everything. We don't know. It just kind of popped up. It's like, hey, every JRPG's got to have a flying castle, doesn't it? We haven't fulfilled our flying castle quota.
Yuri, thank you for saving Flynn.
Go get bitten by ants.
You guys go on ahead first. I'll catch up. I'm not going to tell anyone.
Why?
What do you mean, not going to tell anyone? I mean, I guess Flynn... I guess, actually, yeah, he may not know... I mean, we don't really know if he was unconscious or not, but he was knocked down. But everybody else saw.
Because I can understand why you tried to kill me back there.
I don't. It was fucking stupid as hell. Oh, I'm going to do this for Flynn. I'm going to kill his best friend. Immediately after the existential threat just got summoned. The world-ending threat.
There's something you just want to protect, even if it means dirtying your own hands. You lose your senses in the heat of the moment and find yourself doing things you'd never imagine.
I know what I have done is unforgivable.
Yuri, don't compare your murders to what she did. They're not even close to the same level.
It would have been easier if you'd blame me for this.
Don't flatter yourself. Don't think I'm here doing this for your own good.
The way that was delivered.
I'm not going to put the blame on you just so you can ease your conscience.
What should I do?
Go to prison.
I have no intention of lecturing you about rights and wrongs.
At the very least, tell Flynn. It's fucked up that he doesn't know.
Go figure it out yourself.
Yes, I didn't really think about that until now, that I guess he maybe didn't see what happened.
If you can't, go ask someone you can talk to about this, but not me.
But I mean, Witcher, if Sodia was there, he should have been there.
As Flynn's friend, I'm grateful for the loyalty you've shown towards him.
Oh yeah, so loyal. Kill his best friend. Always remember, it's our picture he's got on the wall. Never fucking forget it.
Yuri's not too fond of young Sodia, is he?
I can see where he's coming from, though. Everything about her feels hard as a rock. That's not exactly easy to like.
She stabbed him!
Ah, cut her some slack. Knights are all a little square. She has a stubborn nature that quick-to-act folks like you and Yuri don't. And that's a good thing.
Stubborn is good? You totally lost me there.
I figured I would. That's why we can't talk without getting on each other's nerves.
Were you guys had your eyes closed too? What is this? Oh, that's the thing with Ifrit. Can we go pop by? Is there anything here now? I'd actually be a little annoyed if there's nothing here. It looks like there's nothing here. But yeah. God, the Patty thing is so silly. That's become my new, like, insult. Things are silly. Okay, there is something here.
Hey, Patty. You do realize that whole thing didn't make any sense, right?
And like, honestly, it not making any sense is like, whatever. The thing that annoys me more is the fact that nobody cared.
Cypher made this tomb, right? So, what happened with the whole Black Hope thing? Why are you a 10-year-old? Why'd everybody turn into monsters?
I've had a theory ever since we met Cypher. I read that a sudden influence of dense air can do that to the body. Happens more often than you think. We've literally never heard of it happening a single time across the entire course of the game, which has been completely and totally focused on what air does. But who would do such a thing and why? My money's on Alexei. Never thought I'd hear that name again. Siren's Fang escorted the Black Hope at Alexei's request. He could have used some sort of formula on board the ship. He experimented on the entire crew? That's terrible, but why? Yeah, I think that all adds up.
Adds up how?
Well, suppose he was trying to conjure the Child of the Full Moon. They're about as powerful as Estelle, and they need their power to revive Zaude. And that little scheme turned Cypher and all the others into monsters. Monsters that Cypher put out of their misery with his blade. And Ifrit ended up taking the fall? Don't worry about me, I haven't suffered nearly as much as Cypher and the others. I just did what I had to do. I just wish I hadn't been injured. That's all in the past. Alexei's dead too.
Did the patent sword belong to Cypher?
Aye. They were what helped restore my memory. I can't believe you had your memory back this whole time. You're saying this is Cypher's resting place too? Say what? Once Cypher transformed, he probably wanted to wipe himself off the map. So he dug his own grave. Are you crying again? I told you my motto, didn't I? Crying gets you nowhere. Alright. The explanation? Literally, a wizard did it. Basically. Whatever. I don't care. I mean, on one hand, at least they explained it. On the other hand, it's hidden in a side area. Yeah, I don't really know what Patty added to this game.
And I think the only thing that could make me dislike her more is pulling that actually she's like a 50 years old, even though she looks like a 10 year old, because that's one of my most hated tropes. Baul? I hit the button 25 times. Alright, where am I going? I'm going to Dongrist. Okay, we're actually not gonna, we're gonna save, but we'll start making our way over. We're going to Nordopolica as well. But we'll get it right outside. But yeah, the section with Flynn and stuff, that was actually pretty cool. I enjoyed that. Honestly, the game as a whole probably should have had more Flynn. Because, like, the dynamic between Flynn and Yuri is also pretty interesting and well done. They could have maybe gone a bit deeper on it, but overall, it's good. Yeah, we'll call it here. I'm ExtraCheesy87. Stay tuned for the next part. And bye, guys.